Welcome back to more Final Fantasy XIII-2, everyone. So last time, we were in Brescia Ruins, defeated Atlas. Yeah, we kicked his ass, and now we're going to go over here.
Upheavals transform the world of man. Nature tirelessly weaves her tapestry. The Sunleth Waterscape survives amidst the decaying cities of Cocoon. This was once a protected wilderness zone, and even without the Falsi overseers, the landscape flourishes. Yet amidst the teeming growth, the seeds of destruction are being quietly sown.
Alright, let's go ahead and tap it and begin this Royal Ripeness battle. I'm gonna be honest. This Royal Ripeness battle is pretty brutal, and I don't know if I'm gonna be able to do it honestly. I might actually not. The only reason why I'm here at the moment is because I want to get that Moogle Throw ability ASAP. To essentially, like, you know, cut some time off, but I don't know if I'll be able to do it now. If I can't do it, then unfortunately what I'm going to have to do is actually just go back and take on Yasuo's Massive or some shit like that. I don't know. We'll see. Hopefully I can do it, though. Hopefully I can. I'm just begging. Oh my god. Well, here we go. Sunleth Waterscape 300 AF.
Each reunion is a twist of the knife. The joy is ephemeral. It leaves fear in its wake. A fear that all too soon the time will come when you must bid farewell again. Yet you cannot help but long for the next encounter. Humanity's great frailty. We prefer past happiness to future uncertainty.
So this is what the end of the world looks like.
Are they going to destroy the planet?
I don't know. But if the world does end here, my future should never have happened. Which means there must be a way to stop them. So, what is it? What's wrong?
The daughters of the Sundered Cocoon are sacrificed to beasts that warp time itself. The pillar crumbles to ash and sand, and down to earth. The cocoon does fall.
What? What? Sarah. Sarah! Sarah!
No!
Wait! Sarah! What's wrong? Was it a vision? Does Sarah have the same power as Yule?
Okay, rather strange, huh? Rather strange, but that's okay. Let's take a look at what the hell we are doing here. So, we're currently kind of in the middle of nowhere, as you can sort of see. Because, you know, you can always tell by, like, moving the map in certain directions, and that's kind of, you get an idea of where the map stands.
But why?
But yeah.
Why did she react the way she did?
Alright, so, now this area here has multiple places. Can I actually go this way, though? Can I? No, I can't. I guess I can. Wait a minute, though. Because aren't I supposed to get the, or am I gonna die over here? Well, I actually can't do shit over here. Alright, so never mind. I'm gonna go back. Also, yeah, there's a huge, flan right there, as you can see. And I am not looking forward to it, because I might actually die, like I keep saying. Oh my god,
wow.
Who the hell knows?
That is one gigantic monster.
Snow, is that really you? I can't believe it.
Sarah, am I dreaming again? Dream or not, we gotta get out of here.
I'll give you a hand. No, I'll hold it off. You get out of here.
Hey, kidding? Was Sarah watching? I don't think so.
Fine, we'll do it together.
Alright, so get a guest character for this battle. Yes, you do, but the problem is that this guy, I think it's pretty freaking hard. So let's just take a look at what's going to happen. I'm going to do a zap. Let's try that move, sure. What the hell? That shit doing? What the heck was that? I actually have no idea what that was, but okay. I'm just going to keep attacking. I'm going to switch to Delta attack, like, right now. And just go ahead and attack. Now, the Pulse Knight itself is actually really, really good. Obviously, I gotta just keep spamming some potions, and okay, that wasn't... Alright, that was good, that was good. Again, the Pulse Knight helps. And just keep using potions, really. But it gets pretty ridiculous, like, how much you can actually get hit in the long run. So I recommend just keep spamming potions to try and beat this guy. Alright, he's about to get staggered, and he is actually staggered. But the problem is, oh boy. How much damage will that do? Okay, that wasn't actually too bad. I guess I'm doing alright for now. That freaking poison, man. That freaking poison. Oh boy. Damn it. Just keep spamming shit. Keep attacking and do whatever. Also, wait, is he getting that much HP, seriously? Oh my god. There's a reason why he's not actually dying easily. Oh my god, that's a lot of damn damage, like seriously. Alright, let's switch to Solidarity. And then heal now, as you can clearly see. Wait a minute, who the hell am I controlling? Why am I controlling you? I actually just noticed that. I don't really care though, because that's fine actually, that's alright.
Get close, I'll cover you! Don't be a fool! Trust me!
Alright, cinematic action. Okay, I guess I did a little bit of damage or something. I don't know what the hell I did, actually. Oh, no. You know what? Go ahead and attack. I want you to attack. Disconnected from the access point? What the hell does that mean? Oh, sorry. No, it was a notification that appeared, but I actually don't know if, like, that was weird, but I'm not entirely sure if that's going to be picked up on the capture card. It might actually be, but I don't know for a fact, really. But anyway, gotta switch. Oh shoot, gotta switch back into You know what? I could probably try even dodge. Let's try that. Let's give some, you know, protection and everything. Because we for sure must deal with this guy, as you already know. Ooh. Okay. This will of course improve us by a pretty good amount, I'm assuming. Let's also do shell. Why not? And I believe that's all he can actually do, though. Yeah, no, that's all you can do. Well, wait, are you targeting snow? Oh, you can also target... I didn't know that. That's cool. Let's switch back into Delta attack now. Okay, what are you doing? Alright. Not entirely sure what that actually did, though. I have no idea, but... whatever. Another belch, huh? Another freaking belch. Well, at least I staggered him. That's not too bad, right? That's not terrible. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Okay, just going to keep spamming potions. Do whatever I possibly can. Right, I'm gonna try that. Let's see if this actually works a little bit better, possibly. I don't freaking know. Like, I don't know. The problem is that he's healing. And that's just not a good thing. Damn it. Because he has somewhat of like a regen, so you have noticed that. That's... oh, god. That's so annoying. He's healing too much HP. That's because what I'm going to have to do, unfortunately, is go more offensive. I'm going to have to switch back into Relentless a couple times here and there if I actually want to have, you know, the ability to kill this guy, but... it's just pretty damn difficult. I mean, luckily these are D-Shell and D-Protect, and that is, of course, helping a lot. Because it helped him do a lot of damage, but even with that, like, I'm just, oh, god. Okay, just going to do some more attacks. The poison's gone, but it's about to come back, I believe. Probably, yes. Oh my god. What the hell? Shoot. I'm down to, I don't know how many potions. I actually didn't take a look right now, but that's okay. That's alright. You know, I'm going to switch to this. It might be risky, I know, but whatever. Also, I'm gonna try this again. Just do whatever you possibly can. I mean, holy crap. Okay. I don't know how much damage it actually did, but whatever. Alright, let's switch back into Zelda for a little bit. Oh man, no. Gotta do this. Fast. Land both. Land deeper tank. Uh-oh. Alright, go ahead and do this now. See, sometimes when you use Feral Link Attack, I didn't mention this, but when you do this, sometimes it can actually interrupt some of their actions, like the enemies do. And I don't know, it's pretty interesting, it really is. Alright, there we go. Back to pretty much full health. I've gotten down to more than halfway, and that's looking good for now. It really is, but I just gotta be a little bit more careful. Okay, I'm gonna switch back into this right now, Delta Attack. Again, Delta Attack works, and there's a reason why I actually gave that much HP to that Pulse Knight. The thing is, though, I'm also going to be using this guy in the long run, which is why I was actually kind of okay with this. How much damage did it actually do? I actually don't know. But whatever. Because I can even tell, like, this guy is so big that when my allies use a Feral Link ability, I'm like, what the heck? And now, I guess the good news is that Snow also helps a little bit for this situation, you know? I guess it's not entirely, like, a big game changer, but you never know, right? You never know. How many points am I down to? 14? That's actually not bad. I can do this, because look at his HP. He's down to, like, that much now. D-Shell and D-Protect help, like I keep saying, so make sure to use this, because it's going to help in the long run a lot. Okay, I'm going to switch back into Delta Attack. Alright, just keep trying to stagger this guy. Keep trying, come on. Oh, damn it. Almost there, almost staggered. There we go, he's staggered. Okay, this might not actually be the final stagger, unfortunately, but... Oh, what the hell is that? What the hell is that? I have no idea what that is, but it looks scary. Oh, shoot. This is not good, people, this is not good. So switch back into this. Okay, I got the shell. And I got the protect again. So that's good. I was going to switch into solidarity for a little bit. He's under haste. That's one thing I don't like. He's under haste now. Oh my god. Alright, back into Delta Attack. Hopefully I can actually do it this round. I mean, he's still staggered. That's kind of a good thing, of course, because I'm doing a lot of damage, but... Oh. Damn, I was doing damage per hit? Holy crap, that's actually a lot of damage. Uh-oh. Oh, shoot. You see, his attacks are also... I think they're getting rid of my buffs, aren't they? I'm pretty sure they are. Because, like, I'm putting Protect and Shell, like, right away, and for some freaking reason... It's like wearing off like right away. I'm not entirely sure why, but I'm pretty sure it's because his moves actually do that, you know? Let's go ahead and do this again. See, are those attacks even working? I have no idea. It doesn't seem like they're working. It does not seem like it. Oh my god. Okay, go ahead and do one more set of attacks. And I'm gonna go and use a potion, or a couple at least. Yeah, I'm gonna use a second one just to be safe. Okay, just a tad bit more. Come on. I'm gonna do three attacks. Three, hurry up. Is that enough? Yes, it was enough.
This jelly bean's ticking me off. Come on, all together! Now! With ya! Yeah, do it! See if you like this!
Ah! Alright, so as you can see, that was a terrible rating, but that's okay, because all I wanted to do was clear it, and I also got a perfect cinematic, sequence thing, so that's good. Crystal Heart, alright.
Just won't stay dead.
Let's go.
Yeah, hit it hard while it's down, you know?
I mean, we get out of here. Look, that way.
Come on, Snow. Let's go.
Hey, Sarah.
Listen, potheads who can't back down don't last long on this planet.
Maybe. Sometimes you gotta make a stand.
You're not listening to me. Humans aren't strong. They die easy.
Well, some of us are tougher than others. Anyway, thanks for the help. You got a name?
Kobo. This is Noel. And this is Snow. We're getting married.
It's on hold for now.
You know, somehow I didn't expect you to be such a hothead. All I hear is what a great guy Snow is. And look where you are, all the way in the future.
I'm sorry, who's the hothead? What were you thinking bringing Sarah out here?
Listen, Snow. Guess what, Lightning? I found Snow again. He hasn't changed a bit. Still as reckless as ever, still doing his own thing. To think I spent all that time worrying about him. Stupid me. Guess I'll never learn. And that's how we got here.
Kupu.
Now it's your turn. Why did you up and leave Sarah? What are you doing fighting here in the future?
You really want to know?
I asked, didn't I?
Lightning appeared in my dreams too. Can you believe it?
You saw Lightning?
She told me I had to protect Cocoon, so I started jumping through time, checking things out. I learned that the giant jelly bean back there knocks Cocoon down.
You mean the Flan we just fought?
Uh-huh.
According to the stories I heard back in my own time, Cocoon was brought down by war.
Well, there's more than just one cause. Did you see what it was doing, that Flan? It's melting the crystal of the pillar, bit by bit.
But Vanille and Fang, they're inside it.
Yeah, so Cocoon starts to get unstable. People feel the tremors and begin to panic. Next thing you know, everyone's fighting each other.
Mm. It's consistent with what I know, sort of.
I can't believe Lightning appeared in your dreams as well. She told you to protect Cocoon's pillar. So she must want you to save Vanille and Fang.
Like I said, sometimes you gotta make a stand. I don't have a choice. My mission is to stop that thing for good.
Snow's here because of something Lightning said in his dream. What else does he know? Let's defeat the Flan. She's still alive? Are Vanille and Fang okay? Was it really her? Let's see. I guess I'm gonna put... Actually, oh my god, I don't know. Obviously not Triangle, because screw that. It's too boring. She's still alive, was it really her? They're kind of similar. I kind of want to press square just to see. Let's press square.
Are Vanille and Fang still safe? If the stories about Cocoon collapsing are true, we'd better hurry.
No worries, I got it covered. That's why Lightning asked me. She knew she could rely on me to protect them and the pillar. 100%.
I'll help you.
So will I. There's no telling how many people will die if Cocoon falls. None of this makes sense. There are thousands of Flan appearing out of nowhere, and they're fusing and creating a beast that shouldn't exist.
Could it be a paradox,
Kobo?
If it is, we'll need to do some traveling to fix it.
Which means you've got to find an artifact first.
Lightning, did you meet Snow in his dreams? Is there a reason why you can only talk to us when we sleep? Snow hasn't changed one bit, even though it's been years since I last saw him. He's still as hot-headed as the day we said goodbye. It makes me so mad. But it's a relief, too. I've been caught up in the fate of the world for so long. It feels good to worry about the simple stuff. Being with Snow helped me forget about what the future might hold.
Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and actually change partners because screw this. I prefer using Sarah in this game as the leader for some freaking reason. Anyway, I'm gonna open up this freaking item. Wait, actually, did I miss something? Open. What do you mean open? Obtain. Dude, get over there, Sarah. Or doodad, sorry. Did I miss anything here? I don't think I did. I'm pretty sure I'm good. Well, I'm leaving. I'm leaving all you people. Okay, let's just go that way then. So let's see. I actually have to go back down that way to the south. So I just have to find somewhere.
There are so many little flans. Where are they all going to?
You follow them straight to the artifact. Well, maybe.
It could happen. They may be drawn by the space-time disturbance. Let's find out.
Where is the artifact? Well, I could search for it, or I could just not. And a part of me actually feels like I probably shouldn't do this. I just want my. Oh, what the hell? Is there an item here?
Get across.
Got it. If we get stuck, just look for a vine.
Why are you shining? I don't know what that means. I mean, he's shining. I thought there was something there, but apparently not. All right, so I'm just gonna go ahead and write this down, and then keep going back south. Now from here, I'm just gonna go. Well, I gotta take this pathway, obviously southwest, but okay.
I had to if I wanted to find you and Lightning again.
Sorry, I left you late. This is all over.
Let's see. Now, I think if I keep going this way to the southwest, I'm pretty sure that it's gonna lead to a cutscene in just a little bit about some Moogle throw thing.
End of the road. We have to turn back. Come on. No way we can take that.
Hey! Snowball! Over here!
Don't encourage it!
Hey, big guy, we need to get through this valley. Mind giving us a ride?
I don't think it hurt you.
No answer. Guess I'll take that as a yes.
It'll swallow you whole.
Well, let's find out!
Snow!
Bouncy.
Is it angry?
Think so. I think he actually likes it.
Yeah, he just had an itch that needed scratching. Come aboard, help me out.
Okay.
Okay, so as you can see, we are riding. I don't know if it's like Anki or something, but.
No, it's too far for me, Kupo.
Okay, I'll throw you closer.
Kupo!
Good idea. We can broaden our search radius.
Sarah, please! Save Mom, Kupo! Good luck.
Alright, so this area right here is where you're actually going to be learning this new thing. The bonds of trust between you and your winged companion have enabled you to perform the Moogle throw. When you see a treasure sphere or another object far beyond your reach, press L1 to grab the Moogle and line up your aim. Without releasing the button, press R1 to send the Moogle flying off to search the area. Okay. Let's try it. So here we go. Moogle throw tutorial. Wait, didn't you already tell me? What the hell? I'm gonna skip this tutorial, because screw this. Alright, so basically, oh man, that's actually really freaking inverted. Jesus Christ. Did you get it? I think you got it.
I think he's in a good mood.
Maybe he's looking forward to the free lunch.
Yep, there we go.
Nice. If he does attack, think of something.
You obtain a silver bangle.
Nice.
The thing is though, you actually have to make multiple trips to obtain all those items to make it there. And I clearly did not, as you can see. So I'm gonna have to go back. Now I have to go back anyway, because I am pretty much done in the Sunleth Waterscape for now. I guess I'll... Sure. I'll go this way. Also, there's an item back here. I kind of want it. What? Well, fine. Here, take this. What?
money.
Oh boy. Maybe this was a bad idea here. Because I don't know how tough this guy actually is. If he's tough... Well, I mean, obviously I can't see right now, but let's take a look. Okay, that doesn't seem so tough. Even if he attacks me, I'm pretty sure I can take a couple hits. Yeah, that's fine. That's alright. Man, this freaking enemy ruined it. Jeez. Also, how much HP did I get from killing that huge-ass flame? I don't completely remember the exact amount, but I'm pretty sure it was like less than 1,000. Which I find strange because this is actually like much later in the game where you're supposed to be. You know, there's a lot I have to do before I get here to the Sunleth Waterscape. Even though I'm skipping this, you know? I mean, you'll kind of see. Alright, so that gives me 100 CP, some stuff, alright. Okay. Open it. Mog. Alright, 7 Vitality Chips. Yeah, I guess I'm all done here. I'm just gonna go back now, and hopefully I can get another item on the way back. But we'll see. Alright, here we go. So, there's actually... What the heck? Also, what the hell is that? I think that's an artifact of some sort. I actually need to prepare this, because I'm not entirely sure. Alright, line it up, line it up. I think it reached. It should have reached.
I think he's in a
good
mood.
Yeah, he got it.
Maybe he's looking forward to the free lunch.
A wild artifact, nice. Now in here, I need to... Oh shoot. No, that's fine, that's fine. So yeah, that's another one. I'm missing only one item, which is actually that one. But again, you gotta make multiple trips to actually get them all. Mana chips. Alright. Jeez, this is so freaking slow, people. Alright, let's go. What? Okay, there we go. So we're all set. All I have to do now is just find the exit, which I think it's to the... Yeah, it's over there to the right. So let's do it. Let's go. Also, wait one second. I need to take a look at something, because... What the hell is this? I always forget this. It opens crystal gates. Interesting. Alright. Because I'm actually forgetting the purpose of opening, like, birds. I mean, closing, yes. Well, what the hell? What are you detecting? Is there something here? Oh, wait. What? What? Oh, yeah, there actually is. Oh, wait. Those are enemies. Oh, no, I'm moving. What? Okay, that's weird. All I'm gonna do is just take this damn... Wait, where's the freaking teleporter? Can I not use it? Oh, I can. I was like, what the hell? Because it's not appearing, but alright, there we go. Like, it was appearing black in the map, and I was like, what the heck is this? But anyway, I'm going back because I have the Moogle Throw ability now, so next time, I'm actually gonna meet you in Brescia Ruins. Because I believe that there's actually something to do there to go back there with this freaking Moogle Throw ability. So yeah, if you enjoyed this episode in any way, please be sure to leave a like. I'd appreciate that very much. Thank you, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye, everyone.